In this video, we will discuss about the car charging system or car alternator. As you know, car charging system is a very, very much important system on any vehicle. The charging system, what it is doing is, it is charging a battery which is there in your vehicle, and that system is very, very much important. Without a charging system, you cannot run your vehicle, because the charging of battery is utmost important. And also, this charging system is providing power to all of your vehicle electrical system or all of your accessories. It is powering up. So which components are involved in charging system is, of course, first is the battery, second is the alternator, and third one is the meter. The meter is not important for this one, but it is only showing a charge indication which is there in the meter. So we will discuss about the wiring of this system here in this video. So you know that battery ground is grounded, the negative of the battery is grounded, and that's connected to the body, and then positive is coming, and then there is a very huge fusing link which is FL main, and through this fusing link, this power is going to another fuse, that's a small fuse, 7.5 ampere alternator B fuse, it is known in Toyota, and another fuse which is also a huge link, that is 120 ampere alternator fuse, that is there in the fuse box. And this link, through this link, this terminal, this wire is connected to the B terminal of the alternator, and this B terminal is a huge bolt on the alternator body which is there, and this wire is directly connected to this one, and that's through a lug connection, and then there is a nut which is tightening this connection. So this is the way how it is connected, and then afterwards this 7.5 ampere fuse wire is going to the alternator C connection, and that's through pin number 1 it is connected, and this one of course is the sense wire, and this is sensing two things. One is the voltage and second one is the current. So how it is doing is, the voltage from here, it is taking the battery terminal voltage and it is telling to the IC regulator internal to the alternator that now the battery is charging, and this much is the charging state. So how much you have to produce, that is decided by this IC regulator, and that is sensed through this sense wire that is connected to pin number 1, and then this IC regulator is deciding how much power I have to produce, and that is feeding up the field winding which is inside the alternator rotor. So this field winding is fed through two carbon brushes and two slip rings, and then this power is provided to the rotor or field, and then this field is producing the magnetic field, which is again producing magnetic flux in the, that flux is cutting in the stator or the armature, and that is delta connected three phase alternator armature. You can see over here, this is the delta connected armature which is feeding bridge rectifier, a three phase bridge rectifier, six diodes, and that's positive is provided over here, and that positive is going to the B terminal as well as it is going to the IC regulator. So how current control is, this was the voltage control, and how current control is, this wire is bringing the voltage which is over here coming, and then this also, this link is giving voltage to this IC regulator, and this IC regulator is looking to the difference of these two voltages, and it is measuring the voltage drop over here, and the voltage drop is directly proportional to the current in this wire. So if the current is very, very much high, so then this IC regulator is reducing the current through the field winding, and that field winding is reducing the flux, and that flux is controlling the armature current. So this is the control, two controls are there, current control and voltage control, of course. So this is, and then there is another terminal which is connected, this green wire is connected to IG fuse, and that IG fuse, you know, that is also coming to the IC regulator, pin number 2, and that is giving the current which is required to power up this field winding. So that's coming from the IG position of the key, and that is provided to the IC regulator, because this alternator is not self-excited, this is separately excited alternator. There are two types of alternator, as you know, self-excited and separately excited. This is separately excited alternator, and that pin number 2 is providing current to the, for the field winding, and there is, of course, inside there is a control how much current is to be fed to the field that is decided by the IC regulator, and that is through this sense wire and through this B wire. Then another terminal is of course this 3 number terminal, which is coming on the C connector, and that terminal is split into two. The blue wire, you can see, one is going to the ECM. It is telling to the ECM that alternator is now running and this much is the charging state. Then the other one is of course AC amplifier assembly, that is going to the AC amplifier assembly, and this wire is giving signal to the AC amplifier assembly that now the alternator is producing its current and everything is okay, so you can switch on the air conditioner. This is one condition for the AC to switch on, that the alternator should run and this should produce power and everything should be okay and the engine should be started, and that is done through this wire. Then the fourth wire is of course this yellow wire. That's why very, very much important here in this discussion, because that is going, you can see, that is going to the charge state indicator. This is an LED, you can see, which is connected to the battery. You can see over here, this battery is coming over here, this line, and then the other line is coming from the IG, and that is coming over here to this 5 volt IC regulator. This both powers are coming to the 5 volt IC regulator, and there is a CPU which is fed through this 5 volt IC regulator, and then there is an LED driver which is driving this LED, and this wire is important for this one. If there is any problem with the alternator, this LED is coming. So while you are driving normally, this LED should not come. There should be no indication of charging like this. But if you are driving in some worst condition, then if your alternator is not good or something like that is happening, then this LED will come. So that's showing, that's telling to the driver that now the conditions are not good. You have to stop the car, vehicle, as soon as possible, and you have to go to the electrician and check up your vehicle, check up your alternator. This is the purpose of this LED. This is coming in the switching on, of course, but that is only this lamp test, and that is telling to the driver that everything is okay, your LED is also okay, and your connection is intact, everything is okay. That's important. And then there is of course a ground to this one, and another thing is this alternator body is grounded. This negative, you can see from this rectifier, this is grounded, and these grounds are virtually connected, or physically even they are connected through body. You can see battery ground, alternator ground, each and every ground is connected together. So this was the way how it works. Hope you learned something. If you learned something, give a big thumbs up, subscribe my channel, and press on the bell icon, so then you will get notifications on each upload. Thank you for watching.